remove the fastening bolts of the pump cover. Insert the jack screw into the jack screw hole reserved for the pump cover, and screw in the jack screw crosswise and evenly until the pump cover is ejected. Remove the rotor guard plate. If limited by space, you can remove the upper screw first, then start the pump, and let the rotor rotate 180 degrees, so that the screw at the other end of the guard plate faces upwards, and then disassemble, then the guard plate can be removed. Loosen the bolts on the left roller support arm. Shrink the roller support arm until it is confirmed that the hose can be taken out smoothly, and then tighten the roller support arm bolts. Remove the inlet and outlet hose pipe clamp bolts and pipe clamps. Remove the inlet and outlet flange bolts. Remove the inlet and outlet flange bolts. It is labor-saving to adopt rotation and take out and pull out linkage. Take out the hose in the pump cavity. Next, demonstrate the installation of the new hose. Insert the new hose into the pump cavity. Adjust the hose to the most suitable position. Rotate the inlet and outlet flanges into the hose. Make the hose port align with the flange paint line, and the alignment is successful. Tighten the inlet and outlet flange bolts. Install the inlet and outlet hose clamps and tighten the bolts. Start the pump and let the rotor rotate 180 degrees. Loosen the bolts of the right roller support arm. Extend the pressure roller until it is aligned with the zero position of the support arm. After restoring the factory pressure defaults, tighten the arm bolts. Install back the rotor guard plate and tighten the screws. Reinstall the pump cover and tighten the bolts.